Hello everybody, thank you all for tuning to a new episode of How to DIY, How to Make an Unbreakable $5 Trailer Plane. Episode, I don't know, but almost the last. In this episode, I don't have to show you how to build the plane. You know how to add all the components on the right place. Probably many of you have a question of where to place the main wing on the body. But to know that, you need to know and find the CG. That's what this episode is all about. You're going to learn what is the CG, how can you find the CG, and how do you set up the main wing on the proper place of the body. Because the nice thing about the CG is that you can't see it. And it's actually a ballast point. And if you know where the main wing balance is, about 25% of the leading edge. And the CG is not actually at the underside of the wing. It's actually on the inside. So it's not at the top, it's not at the bottom, it's in the middle. And 25% of 15 centimeters, that is 37 millimeters. And we mark the spot so that makes it a little bit easier to later on when we have made the plane to find the CG and set it correct and know if it is not too nose heavy or too tail heavy. Because this is what you're all going to learn, and how to find the CG of the wing that we just did. And now we're going to find the CG of the body. But for that we have to add all the pieces together. So we're going to put the landing gear to the front, add the battery at the front, and then of course the tail to the rear and the two servos. And then about in the middle, we're gonna place the receiver for now. I'm gonna pick up the landing gear and I'm gonna be facing forward. This is how we're gonna place it underneath the body, close to the front, but of course be careful that the prop doesn't gonna hit the wheel. So we're gonna place it a little bit to the rear, just behind the support. And just make sure, of course, that it is completely even. I marked the center of the body at the underside, and we did the same thing for the landing gear. So I can line it up right that center. And make sure that everything is perfect. That's it for the landing gear. Just make sure that the screws are not longer and not sticking out the body, because we're going to place the battery right about here somewhere. Now we have added the receiver, we have added the 5-volt back to power up the receiver, we have added the battery, we just all tape it just temporarily, just to find the place. Maybe we can change it up later, but just to find the CG of the body, we have added all the components, even the propeller. Now we only have to add the tail, and to mount the tail section to the rear, you of course can use wood glue, hot glue, good double-sided tape, or two popsicle sticks and 2 or 4 little screws. And just make sure that everything is lined up nice and perfect, of course. That's the main important thing. Everything needs to be level. When you're setting the servos, make sure that they are centered up, and that as well that the rudder and elevator are completely nice and centered and level. Then it's time to glue them down with hot glue. Now we just let the hot glue dry out for a couple of minutes, making sure it's really hardened out. And then we're going to add and find the CG of the body. But now we have all the weight, all the electronics, everything's on the body. Now it's just finding where does the body balance. Nose heavy. Tail heavy. In between. Slightly nose heavy. Okay. Oh. And my best guess is that here is the CG. And of course, we're going to mark that on the side of the body. That's not a problem. So now we have found the CG of the body. Now you also maybe know why I'm making it so nose heavy. Because the more weight at the nose, the CG from the plane will go forward. The tail is more heavy, then the CG will be going backwards. And we are going to line up the CG from the body with the wing. And the more space between the wing and the tail, because it's like a leverage system, the longer the distance is between the elevator and the wing, the more force it got with a little movement. That makes it the tail can be small and light. As long as it's got a good distance between the tail and the main wing, you got plenty of leverage to steer the plane in any direction. When we are going to add the wing and the wing support to the body, and we know that the CG is at 25% of the wing, that means that 75% of the wing and the wing support is going to sit behind the CG, and that makes the tail heavier. And to counterbalance for that, we're going to jump 1 centimeter. So the CG of the body is over here, the CG of the wing is about there, line those two up. CG of the wing, CG of the body. Normally they were perfect, but we got 75% that we are going to add to the tail weight. So we need to move the wing a centimeter and a half sometimes, depending on how much and how big the plane is. But this is how I built and scratch built. And make sure that the CG of the body and the wing are almost already correct. So I know that there's almost no weight I have to add to the nose or to the tail to make it fly good. Sometimes people build a plane and then find out that the nose is too light and the tail is too heavy, and then they're going to add more weight and more weight, unnecessary weight in the form of lead or an extra battery that they don't really need. That's why I always find the CG, add all the components to the body, find the CG of the body, find the CG of the wing, that is almost about 25%, and then line them up and then put a centimeter or a centimeter and a half more to the rear, and you will always be correct, and then you can always still play with the battery to find the perfect CG for the plane. But it also goes together with the thrust angle. That's all for the test flight. Now we have found the wing, we found the place, we know what we do, and now we're going to add the wing support to the body and then add the wing on top. So we added the main wing support and we added some hot glue and two screws, that makes a very strong connection. Now we're going to add the main wing on its place by using double-sided tape and then two rubber bands to hold it in place. To hold the rubber bands are going to hold the main wing on its place, we are going to use four little screws. I'm going to place them close together so we can put a rubber band over it and make it sure it's tight. So we're going to place one here and one another there. Now I just marked the center of the wing so I can line it up with the body that we have marked with the center, of course. Now I don't have to remove this double-sided tape and make sure that everything is level. You only have one chance, it's going to be really sticky. It's one go. Nice 90 degrees, and this side also 90 degrees, nice dead on, perfectly aligned. Now it's time for the rubber bands to add to the wing as an extra security backup if the double sided tape decides to let go. Now the wing is in its place, we have to put already the service wire in the receiver, it's all nice lined up, all ready to go. I'll just for last I will give you the diameter, the centimeter, the distance between the tail and the main wing at the rear end is 28 centimeters. And that is enough distance to get enough leverage from the tail, from the rudder and the elevator to make this plane fly and turn perfectly nice. I will can't wait for the test flight and test if the CG is correct, if the thrust angle is correct, because now we have marked the CG, so now we can lift up the wing and see if it balances out right at the markings that we made at the underside of the wing. And it feels really good, seems to be out perfectly level. I really hope you like this episode and give this of course a thumbs up. If you have any questions, then leave them down below in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe and click that notification bell so you don't miss the next episode where we're going to do the maiden flight. And a couple of test flights to make sure that the thrust angle and the CG and everything is correct. I really hope to tune in for the next time. I'm going to say goodbye and thank you all for watching.